Okay, so we have seen that, given a square matrix, you can write down an eigenvalue equation, and owing to the fundamental theory of algebra, we'll always be able to find, as many eigenvalues as the dimension of the matrix. Sometimes some of these eigenvalues may be repeated, but the eigenvalue equation is, always yields n roots. But on the other hand, there are cases where matrices may not give you, enough eigenvectors to span the overall space, right? So the best way to understand this is with the aid of some examples, which we will look at in this lecture. Okay, so matrices whose eigenvectors are unable to span the overall space, they are called defective matrices, right? If the number of linearly independent eigenvectors of the square matrix is less than the dimension of the matrix, right? Such a scenario appears when you have a defective matrix, right? So necessarily all defective matrices have at least one degenerate eigenvalue, repeated eigenvalue, right? Because we have seen that, corollary to one of the theorems which we discussed in the previous lecture is that if you have all non-repeated eigenvalues, if you have distinct eigenvalues, then you're going to have so many distinct and linearly independent eigenvectors. And if you have n eigenvectors which are linearly independent, that's going to span the whole space. So there is no question of such a matrix being defective, right? So defective matrices happen only when there is degeneracy. But not all degenerate matrices are defective, right? So we will just look at some examples of matrices. Two examples we are going to look at. One where degeneracy is a result of the defectiveness of the matrix, and the other cases, where you can have a degenerate matrix but which is not defective. Okay, let's look at the first example, which is, this matrix A equal to 4, 1, minus 1, 2. So the eigenvalue equation is Ax is equal to lambda x. So we have A minus lambda I acting on x is equal to 0. So the characteristic equation is determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0, which is the same as saying determinant of 4 minus lambda 1 minus 1, 2 minus lambda equal to 0. So you expand this out, you have lambda minus 4 times lambda minus 2. Minus minus 1, so plus 1, so that will give you lambda squared minus 6 lambda plus 9. But we see that this is the same as lambda minus 1, lambda minus 3, the whole square equal to 0. So there you see that the roots of this equation are in fact 3 and 3. So you have a repeated root, or repeated eigenvalue, degenerate eigenvalue. So now let's see what happens to the eigenvectors. Let's try and find the eigenvectors, corresponding to this, the two same eigenvalues. Are there two different eigenvectors can we find? Well, let's look at it. So if we plug this back into this equation, right? So this equation, so we and write x as x1, x2. So we have 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1, x1, x2 equal to 0. So you see that the first equation is x1 plus x2 equal to 0, and the second equation is minus x1 minus x2 equal to 0, minus x1 minus x2 equal to 0. So basically both equations are the same, right? So there is no separate content coming from the second equation. Therefore, in fact, you will be able to find only one linearly independent eigenvector, right? 1 minus 1. That's the only eigenvector that you can find from this, from the characteristic equation. So this means that the matrix is defective, right? It's a 2 by 2 matrix, but there is only one eigenvector and there is a repeated eigenvalue, which is 3, right? So now let's look at another example which is actually a kind of a trivial example of a matrix. Again, we'll just stick to a simple 2 by 2 matrix, which is degenerate and which is not defective. If you want to pause the video and try to come up with your own example, please feel free to do so. So the hint is that it's extremely simple. In fact, you might say it's trivial after you look at the answer. So find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix I equal to 1, 0, 0, 1. Right, so this is completely trivial because this is the identity matrix and there is nothing to do. You don't have to even come up with the characteristic equation or anything. Right, so every vector, every non-null vector is an eigenvector of the identity matrix, right? But it's a two-dimensional space, so but there are, you will only be able to find two linearly independent eigenvectors, right? If you take a third one, then that's going to be you'll have a linearly dependent set. So I mean, we are free to pick any two linearly independent vectors, and that's going to, you know, suffice because they're going to be eigenvectors. But let's say we just pick 1, 0, and 0, 1. They are explicitly seen to be both linearly independent and orthogonal. Right? All linearly independent vectors don't have to be orthogonal, but orthogonal vectors are linearly independent. Right? So in this case, I'm just picking 1, 0, and 0, 1 randomly. You may try out some other, and that also is going to work out. So the point is that there is a trivial example of a matrix which admits degeneracy, but which is not defective. Right? So in general, you can have n by n matrices, you know, which may be of either of the above kinds. You can have, you know, higher order degeneracy. You may have three eigenvalues which are repeated, and then you have to closely check whether it's a degeneracy of this kind, which means that there is no defect in the matrix, and then you will still be able to find eigenvectors which will span the space. But on the other hand, this is a more sinister kind of degeneracy. When this happens, the matrix becomes defective, and so the eigenvectors of such matrices are unable to span the space. Right? So in quantum mechanics, we do encounter operators which have degeneracy, but they'll always be of this kind because we work with Hermitian matrices, where we will see that, you know, the Hermitian matrices always are able to give you eigenvectors which will span the overall space. Right? So the point of this lecture is to illustrate that although, you know, the eigenvalue equation is straightforward and any matrix will necessarily have n eigenvalues, although some of them may be repeated, the number of linearly independent eigenvectors that matrices have depends on, you know, the particular type of matrix that you are looking at. And in particular, there are these very pathological matrices which are called defective matrices, where the number of linearly independent eigenvectors may be less than the dimension of the matrix, and one has to be careful about such matrices. So that's all for this lecture. Thank you.